cells in response to the entry of antigen into the body of the host. I repeat my words, students. Antibody is a molecule or chemical substance released by B lymphocytes, modified B lymphocytes, which are called plasma cells, in response to the antigen which enters the body of the host. Now, students, we discuss structure of the antibodies. Structure. Students, in human beings, the antibodies are called immunoglobulins. Keep one thing in mind. All immunoglobulins are antibodies, but all antibodies are not immunoglobulins. Okay? What are immunoglobulins? Students, immunoglobulins are globulin proteins present in the plasma. Okay? What are immunoglobulins? Students, immunoglobulins are globular plasma proteins. Immunoglobulins are globular plasma proteins. Now, we discuss the structure of immunoglobulins. Students, each immunoglobulin is a Y-shaped molecule consisting of two heavy chains and two light chains. Now, students, this is a Y-shaped molecule which represents the structure of typical immunoglobulin. These are this one and this one. It indicates heavy chains. It indicates heavy chains. On the other hand, these reddish, these are lighter chains. Okay? So, we can say that combination of lighter chains along with heavy chains constitute the structure of immunoglobulins. Now, students, this portion, it is variable portion. This portion of Y-shaped immunoglobulin is variable portion. And this all structure, it is constant. This is variable part indicated by dotted lines, and these fixed lines, they are constant part of Y-shaped molecule. Now, the significance of this variable part is that it is the location where antigen binds with these immunoglobulins to produce or to proceed with the process of immunity. Now, students, we discussed with classes of immunoglobulins or types of immunoglobulins. Students, there are 5 different types of immunoglobulins. Number 1, IgG. Students, it is the most abundant immunoglobulin. It is most abundant immunoglobulin present in the, it is present in intravascular compartment and interstitial compartment. Students, intravascular compartment means blood flowing in the vascular system of the host, and interstitial compartment means outside the vascular system, outside the blood vessel. So IgG immunoglobulins, they are most abundant. They are present in the intravascular space, that is inside the blood vessels, as well as interstitial spaces. Students, these are smaller in size. These immunoglobulins, IgG immunoglobulins, they are smaller in size. And it is because of their smaller size that IgG immunoglobulin, they pass out from the blood, they escape the blood vessels and enter the tissue spaces, which is called interstitial space. Okay? Next point is, students, IgG, it fixes the complement. That is, it activates the complement system. So they are an important component of immune system of the body. Okay? Fixes the complement. IgG. Now, students, IgM. Students, IgM is 10 to 15% of the total immunoglobulin ratio in the host. They also fixes the complement. Okay. Number 2, they represent infection in previous days. Okay, students, presence of IgM immunoglobulins, they represent infection by bacteria or viruses in previous days, not in the recent period. Okay? Now, students, IgA, this immunoglobulin, it is present in body secretions like saliva, tears, mother's breast milk, colostrum, and genitourinary secretions. ओके। IgA immunoglobulins, they are present in saliva, tears, breast milk, colostrum, and GIT secretions. Now, students, here I want to mention that IgG is the only immunoglobulin which crosses the placenta. That is, it passes from mother to the fetus, whereas the other immunoglobulins, they do not cross the placenta. Okay, it was all about IgA. Now, students, we move towards IgD. Students, IgD is present on the surface of B cells. Surface of B cells. Their exact function is not known. However, it has been suggested that IgD immunoglobulins are involved in the activation and differentiation of B cells. Now, students, IgE, immunoglobulin E. Students, this immunoglobulin is present on basophils and mast cells. IgE immunoglobulin, it is present on the surface of basophils and mast cells. Students, presence of immunoglobulin E in the host represents parasitic infestation. Immunoglobulin E concentration is raised in the host which is suffering from any parasitic infestation, worm infestation. Okay? IgE is involved in type 1 hypersensitivity reaction, which is called anaphylaxis. Students, immunoglobulin E is involved in type 1 hypersensitivity reaction, which is called anaphylaxis. And this anaphylaxis, it involves chemical mediators which are released by destabilization of mast cells and basophils. And this destabilization, it occurs because of the presence of IgE immunoglobulin. Okay, students, it was brief about different types of immunoglobulins. Now we move towards functions of immunoglobulins. Functions of immunoglobulins. Number one, precipitation. Students, precipitation is the function of immunoglobulins when they form complexes with the antigen, which are called immune complexes, and as a result of this immune complex formation, these immunoglobulins along with combined antigen, they precipitate out of the body fluids. As a result, the antigen becomes more easy for phagocytic cells to be attacked. This process is called precipitation. Number two, agglutination. Agglutination. Students, again, agglutination also involves the formation of immune complexes by antigen antibody complexes, which makes the antigen more easier to be destroyed by phagocytic cells. Number third function, antitoxins. Students, immunoglobulins, they also act as antitoxins to neutralize the effects of bacterial toxins. Okay? And number four and last, opsonization. Opsonization. Students, opsonization means that these antibodies makes the antigen more easier to be attacked by phagocytic cells. These are the four main functions of antibodies or immunoglobulins. That is, number one, precipitation. Number two, agglutination. Number third, antitoxins. And number four, opsonization. Okay, students? Now we discuss some of the laboratory tests which use the presence of antibodies or immunoglobulins for detection of the diseases. Lab tests. Lab test utilizing antibodies. There is a long list of laboratory tests which utilize the presence of antibodies for the diagnosis of different diseases. Most common, students, hepatitis C, hepatitis B, HIV, syphilis, torch infections, it is a combination of different bacteria, that is toxoplasmosis, histoplasmosis, okay, torch, cytomegalovirus, anti-nuclear antibodies, anti-nuclear antibodies, they are used for the diagnosis of SLE disease, which is an autoimmune disease, AMA. Number seven, students, diabetic antibodies, thyroid antibodies, AIDS, rheumatoid, okay. There is a long list of laboratory tests. I have mentioned only some of these laboratory tests which involve detection of antibodies for the diagnosis of a disease.
Students, this was brief about antibodies, immunoglobulins, their structure, types and their functions. Thank you students. Allah Hafiz.
रोक दें
जी.